Okay, Shalom, just really quickly, let's go into this whole let's go into the whole thing about the 10%. Let me just find okay, this whole matter regarding the 10%. Let's just handle this really quick. The 10%, right? Okay, let me just get scripture real quick. Okay, so mostly it's gonna be the book of Numbers, chapter 3, but then there's gonna be some referencing to other scriptures of Exodus and Genesis, but for the most part, just note that. Okay, here, we're gonna start by Gershon, Kohath. And Merari. Okay. Okay, so those that were numbered of the Gershonites, of them were 7,500. A total of 7,500 for the Gershonites. Okay. And as far as the Kohathites were 8,600 keeping the charge of the sanctuary. So 8,600. And the Merarites were a total of it's going to be a total of 6,200, but I got to get to that. So, yes. And note, they're numbering all the males that are 1 month old and older. And so the Fethanagast, it clear in chapter regarding baptism, I think it's the fourth chapter of the Fethanagast. It one of the rules is kind of that every clergyman or like within the service of the tabernacle that his son is not baptized for a full year, that child loses his birthright, he has to go through that whole consecration process again, and so on and so forth. And so interesting to note that this is the second year, like one whole year coming out of the Exodus, and the first month was the book of Levites, and the second month was the book of is the book of Numbers. And so it's been a year and a month, and so that I'm pretty sure that that's what is being insinuated here, that the those that were consecrated in the book of Exodus, which were also the Levites, it's been a year, and since they haven't really baptized, they've lost their priesthood. And so here we go again. So this is the all the males. This total will be all the males that are 1 month old and older. And so, just very important to note as well that. This is also giving I and I a clue as to what kind of prices and what kind of liability these children hold. Because if you go to the book of Leviticus, chapter 27, that whole chapter is giving you detailed information as to like the price of each individual. For instance, every male that is 25 years, 20 years old, even to 60, thy estimation shall be 50 shekels of silver after the shekel of the sanctuary. And so for it's exactly verse 6 of the 27th chapter of the book of Leviticus, verse 6, and if it be from a month old even to 5 years old, then thy estimation shall be of the male 5 shekels of silver. And so 1 month old and above even to 5 years shall be 5 shekels, according, well, let's leave it at that, shall be 1 month old, even to 5 years, shall be worth like 5 shekels, all right, according to the book of Leviticus chapter 27. And I guess let us take this time to go forward to the book of Exodus, which also illuminates on some of these matters. Okay, for example, chapter 30 of the book of Exodus. If you go to verse 13, this they shall give everyone that passeth among them that are numbered half a shekel after the shekel of the sanctuary. A shekel is 20 gerahs. A half shekel shall be the offering of the Lord. So we have this, once again, like a half shekel is an offering, is offering to the Lord, to Geta, to Adonai, and 20 gerahs, which is funny, well, interesting, because gerahs is how you say wars in Spanish. So 20 wars in the skull, maybe, 20 sacrifices shall be equal to 1 shekel. I apologize for the scrap, for the horrible writing, but I just want to do this because there's some stuff I need to handle and try to get through this. Well, I'll take the time to relax now, because just because I said that, it came to mind that Ida is not to rush these things, for they are of great significance and great importance. So, that being said, the writing is going to get a whole lot better. I pray, you know? So, I think it's the 18th chapter of the book of Exodus. Yeah, definitely, it's the 18th chapter. Actually, no. Well, I'll just mention that this 18th chapter, it's like the trumpets are sounded. So it's kind of like this is the process, the calling. And then the whole erecting, erification of, you know, of the tabernacle and so on and so forth. And the stones. Okay, I'm looking for the verse where they explain and give detail to all the prices of the sanctuary. Okay, so in verse in chapter 38 of the book of Exodus, we begin to get detail on, like, and the verse 17 of chapter 38 of the book of Exodus, and the sockets for the pillars were of brass, the hooks of the pillars and their fillets of silver, and so on and so forth, the hangings of the gate, and they're giving 20 cubits on fine twined linen, just, and their pillars were 4, the sockets of their brass 4, and so on and so forth. The pins of the tabernacle and of the court round about were of brass, you know, that brass serpent up on the pole that cures all disease, and you know, just details to take in consideration that express and accurately describe Jesus Christos, you know, prior to his coming, but not prior to his existence, for Jesus was, is, and will always be, and come to be. So, okay, verse 24, and the gold was occupied for the work in all the work of the holy place, even the gold of the offering was 20 and 9 talents, and 730 shekels. So we get this number, 730 shekels. And 29, but let's not go into the 29 at this point. After the shekel of the sanctuary, and the silver of them that were numbered of the congregation was 100 talents, and 1,703 score and 15 shekels after the shekel of the sanctuary. A beka for every man, that is half a shekel after the shekel of the sanctuary, so on and so forth. So go, you know, go over this, and this will give you a good idea of what I and I is to explain right about now. So okay, let's go into the main reason for this for the 10%. Let's go into the whole idea of 10% and so on and so forth. Okay, so I mentioned that the numbering of these three tribes or families, if you count that up, you get a total of 22,300. But in chapter 3 of the book of Numbers, it says that all that were numbered of the Levites, which Moses and Aaron numbered at the commandment of the Lord, of Adonai, Jesus Christos, throughout their families, all the males from a month old and upward were 20 and 2,000. So we get this number, 20 and 2,000. And I started to think, well, what about 300? And so continuing. And the Lord said to Moses, number all the firstborn of all the males of the children of Israel from a month old and upward, and take the number of their names. And so the counting goes on. Oh, my bad, verse 41 of chapter 3. And thou shalt take the Levites for me, I am the Lord, instead of all the firstborn among the children of Israel, and the cattle of the Levites instead of all the firstlings among the cattle of the children of Israel. And Moses numbered as the Lord commanded him, all the firstborn among the children of Israel, and all the firstborn males by the number of their names, from a month old and upward. And those that were numbered of them were 20 and 2,000 and 73. 20 and 2,000, 200 and 73 would be 60 and 15. 60 plus 15 is... Wait a minute. Okay. 20 and 200 and 73 and 13. So that would be 73, a total of 73, 273. So these are the Levites, and these are all the firstborn, all the first lifted, Nasa, Nekesha, you know, lifted up of Israel, and they are to be switched. And that's important to note. The whole flipping. Okay, continuing. Okay, let's pause there and go to the book of Genesis. It's going to be chapter 48. Okay, so it reads. Okay, and now thy two sons, Ephraim, this is Jacob, Israel, talking to Joseph, his son. And now thy two sons, Ephraim and Manasseh, which were born to thee in the land of Egypt before I came to thee into Egypt, are mine, as Reuben and Simeon and Simon, they shall be mine. That being established, continuing, and Joseph said to his father, there are my sons, and God hath given me in this place, and he said, bring them, I pray thee, to me, and I will bless them. Now the eyes of Israel were dim for age, so that they could not see. And he brought them near to him, and kissed them, and embraced them. And Israel said to Joseph, I had not thought to see thy face, and lo, God hath showed me also thy seed. And Joseph brought them out from between his knees, and he bowed himself with his face to the earth. And Joseph took them both, Ephraim in his right hand towards Israel's left, and Manasseh in his left hand towards Israel's right hand, and brought them near to him. And Israel stretched out his right hand and laid it upon Ephraim's head, who was the younger, and his left hand upon Manasseh's head, guiding his hand wittingly, for Manasseh was the firstborn. And he blessed Joseph and said, God, before whom my fathers Abraham and Isaac did walk, the walking of the book of Numbers, and God which fed me all my life long to this day, the angel which redeemed me from all evil, bless the lads, the angel being Jesus Christos that was with them, the 40 days, 40 nights in the temptation, the 40 years in the book of Numbers, bless them, because Jah will send his angel, you know, to be to them, pillar of fire by night and a cloud by day. Continuing, and let my name be named on them, and the names of my fathers Abraham and Isaac, and let them grow into a multitude in the midst of the earth. And when Joseph saw that his father laid his right hand upon the head of Ephraim, it displeased him, and he held up his father's hand to remove it from Ephraim's head to Manasseh's head. And Joseph said to his father, not so, my father, for this is the firstborn, but put thy right hand upon his head. And his father refused and said, I know, my son, I know. He also shall be a people, and he also shall be great, but truly his younger brother shall be greater than he, and his seed shall become a multitude of nations. So the multitude of nations being I and I, a great people, you know, in Rastafari, Rastafari. Okay, and so a lot of interesting notes. The multiplication, it's to be, you know, Ephraim is to be a multitude and of many nations. And so what we get here is what is a division, you know, in the book of Numbers. See, there seems to be a kind of multiplication of division. You know how you get a negative? I really don't recall, but you're kind of getting this, you know, the right hand and the left hand and so on and so forth, and the crossing, and one, it should have been the younger, it should have been the oldest, but it was given to the youngest, and so on and so forth. And this is interesting to know, because it's a reflection of mathematical operations, and but it's how, like, when you're gonna multiply fractions, you're gonna multiply or something, you kind of make this switch 180 degrees, and you know, and something similar to that effect is going on. And which reminds me, if the Huawei, which is which, you know, wehede, is it even that? Give I just 1 second. Well, yeah, recall that last study, and so the brain, and how the left side of the brain, the leftover and the odd number and the strange and the remainder and the fatness and the leftover and the flowing controls the right, and the right controls the righteous, and the right and exact controls the left. And recall how when one has vision, we have this vision like this, and this is what we are able to see, you know. Same thing, the crossing over of one side to another and the other to the other, and making that balance, and that's what's going on here in the book of Numbers again, because Jah tells Moses that he wants, instead of all the firstborn, he wants the Levites. And so and you know, it's that direct link, you know, Genesis chapter 48, it said, let me go forward to it to further discuss it. Okay, the angel which redeemed me from all evil, one Jesus Christos. Now going forward to the book of Numbers chapter 3, once again, once more, probably always, to eternity. So we left off in chapter 3, book of Numbers, verse 46. and for those that are to be redeemed of the 213 of the firstborn of the children of Israel, which are more than the Levites. So are redemption and remainder equals 273. So those that are more, so it would be times those of the children of Israel, the firstborn. Okay, forward to verse 47. Thou shalt take even 5 shekels apiece by the pole after the shekel of the sanctuary shalt thou take them. The shekel is 20 gerahs. So, okay, since I'm not that great at math, this equation may not be, you know, the intended illumination and interpretation of scripture, but just to give an idea how the book of Numbers is in fact a book of numbers and a book of science and politics and economy and law, everything, you know, being that the creator is one, then all within the creation is one as well. And so we're getting the 5 shekels equals 1 piece. And this evidence, if we go forward to Leviticus chapter 27, now we know what age and what children we are talking about. And so 1 piece and 1 shekel equals 20 gerahs, 20 gerahs. And so, if you multiply 5 times 20, that's 100, equaling 1. And so, 20 is 1/5, my bad. Okay, let I not get ahead of myself. But, I'm just going to throw that in there, because this has nothing to do with it, but it's funny. How, you know, son of my right hand is Benjamin, and in Spanish, you know, to call someone to you, you just call them, you know, Ben. You know, Ben. So come over here, you know. And it expresses the simplicity and the, you know, the variety expressed within the original Afro-Shemitic languages, such as the Afro-Shemitic Hebraic language. How it's so practical, you know. It's like, every time, like, the son of the right hand, it's a right hand always to work and, you know, always working and reflecting strength. And so his son, it's very practical and convenient to call him Ben, you know, Ben Yamin, you know, calling Yamin. Because in Spanish, it's like, come over here. It's what you tell your kids all the time, like, Ben, you know, who do you tell Ben to? Your sons. And so that's funny. You know, it reminded me because of the guerras and wars. And this probably has something to do with the wars in our heads, being that there's also a book of wars and so on and so forth. So, you know, that's just a side note, interesting topic. You know, the Spanish has a lot of Hebraic influence, and it's I'm pretty sure it's mostly because of the Moorish influence within the Española. But, you know, that's a whole different topic. But there's a lot of similarities between Spanish and the Hebraic, and even the Ethiopic, because the Spanish language, it contains some of those, like the, for example, the ñ, you know, in Spanish it would be kind of like the ñ, the ñ, and in the Ethiopic it would be the, well, this would be the ñ, but you kind of, well, they even look similar. Well, anyways, and for example, there's so many different kinds of, this is off topic, but one, okay, just because many Rastafari might like this one, but the sin semilla, you know, the ya, which is in the double L in Spanish, is like a different it's like more with more strength than the ya and the ya. Kind of like, it's got some elements to the Hebraic which are interesting to note. And so, some cultures might express sin semilla or sin semilla, like, and as sin semilla, like they can't pronounce that, and which, because it's not for them. But it could be, if they make their wills obedient to I and I, God and Father, one, Haile Selassie, and then through Jesus Christus. But anyways, continuing. And thou shalt give the money wherewith the odd number of them is to be redeemed. The odd is the leftover and the what flows and what is extra. And so the odd number. And Moses took the redemption money of them that were over and above them that were redeemed by the Levites. Of the firstborn of the children of Israel took he the money, 1,303.05 shekels. So we have a total of the redemption money, 1,303.65 shekels. 1,365. And so being that more is a direct it's kind of like directly insinuating that a multiplication. So 1,365 times two, because it is okay, give me just 1 second. Gotta go to the notes. Is 2,730. Make note of that number. And so you divide this number by 10. And your answer is 273. And this is just to kind of give proof that we're on the right track, because those that were more were 273. And so we could go on and so forth with this. So 273 divided by 100 equals 27.3. 300 minus 27 equals 273. Two hundred and 73 times 10 equals 2,730. And well, basically what's going on here, if you get the 5 shekels and 5 times 273 equals 1,365, and so on and so forth. And so this is what I and I concluded. That in some way or another, God is trying to give us clues to, okay, so the total was 22,300, but scripture only counts 222,000. That's because those that were more of the firstborn of Israel were 273. So Jah takes 10% of that, which is more. And so 300 minus 273 are 27. And 0.33 if you want to be exact. But it's 27. And so what was going on is that Jah had already taken the 10%. Right here, because of that whole switching. It may sound confusing, but like it's 10% regardless of how you want to do the math. It's a reflection of that 10%, of giving to Jah, because that which is abundant and wealth and richness that is left over, So, keep that in mind. It was interesting. Another more personal note is that I'm being taxed 2.7%. But I did some counting, and it turns out that in reality I'm being deducted 27%, and the percentile is being moved one space over to the left to the remaining number. And that's it. So for every $100, I'm being deducted $27, being left with a 73, which is interesting because it all makes sense. Babylon doing, using Jai works, good works, and applying them to wrong, and let Babylon be Babylon. Babylon is falling, it's falling. So, continuing on with this, just, little interesting side note to this information is that to be a self-supporting pillar, a free and self supported pillar to Jah, one must give the 10% Ethiopian obelisk. If you know anything about obelisk, it takes 10% of the weight of the whole obelisk to support. So the obelisk, any obelisk, has a weight of 10% of the whole weight down here that supports the whole structure. And just to make this go even farther with this, if you go to Exodus chapter 20, which is the half shekel again, and the half, and the one, and the one half, and so on and so forth, you get the 10. So Exodus chapter 20, you get the 10, the Decalogue, the 10%. If anything, keep the 10 commandments, which are one, which is 10%, of one of 10 is 10%, and two of one is one half, and it just makes sense. The half shekel, and the whole 20, and the 20 gerahs, and the five, and it's interesting to note. Even His Majesty and one Jesus Christos testified to this. Your Imperial Majesty, what advice do you give to the young people, coming into the faith? Follow the Ten Commandments, our father said. Jesus Christos, follow my father's commandment, and my father's commandment is one, even one Decalogue, one word, and 10 applications to that one word. I'm pretty sure that if we count all the laws, the Decalogue will most likely end up being 1/10 of one, I mean 10% of all law. And if we keep those 10%, God willing, we'll be forgiven for our shortcomings and shortfallings, so keep this in mind. It's just like just information, it don't matter if one is not willing to apply it. If anything, numbers will be numbers, but follow the Ten Commandments, I would say. And I'm telling myself as well, And so yeah, let's work on keeping the Ten Commandments. Let's keep the ball rolling. Shalom Rastafari. I pray, I hope that I come soon with some more information on the Book of Numbers that I and I is working on. Best wishes to all the brothers and sisters, and those that are just, viewing this for pleasure. I and I invite anyone that is human, to join the movement for the human community at, in and through Jesus Christos. I'm sure our eldest brother and our father would be more than willing and happy to accept anyone that wishes and seeks in faith and in truth, and with all holiness to conform to the will and to the will of our God. Follow the Ten Commandments. Shalom until then. God bless all and die.